So if you didn't know, Midjourney has version 6 out right now to play around with. What I want to do in this video is to test it out to what we have now, or kind of do a versus. So right now, Midjourney has version 5.2. I'm going to compare it to what version 6 can put out, and I'm going to do it over 5 different categories. Stickers, posters, patterns, coloring pages, and t-shirt designs. And stay till the end because I'm going to test out some other things too. And I want to show you what the differences are right now while it's in alpha. Let's go. Hey everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I wanted to do something really fun and test Midjourney versus Midjourney. That's right, Midjourney default right now, which is version 5.2, and Midjourney version 6, which is right now in alpha, not even beta. We're lucky enough to test it in alpha first. Usually we only see the beta version. Anyway, it does some amazing things already in alpha, and it's gonna do some amazing things in the future when it's fully functional. But I wanted to show you what the differences are and can we see the difference in some of these. They're gonna be very simple prompts. I'm not gonna use anything really hard. In fact, I'm gonna show you all the prompts, and I'm gonna show you version 5.2 and version 6 and show you how to actually use it there. So let's go into Midjourney right now, and I'll show you the different prompts for the different selections that I made. Again, these selections are stickers, posters, patterns, coloring pages, and t-shirt designs. All right, so here we are on Discord. I'm on my own server, or my own place that I can do my Midjourney. Now, Midjourney's right here, you can see right there, and you can set up your own, which is I have here, and it just uses the Midjourney stuff basically on here. So I can do anything with Midjourney on my own server. And the way you can do set up version 6, you can see some of these say version 6. There's two ways you can do it. The first way is really easy. You just do slash settings right there, and you got to hit it twice for some reason. And then when you pull it up, you can see this one is already on version 6, but this is the default right here, version 5.20. You can dial it all the way back, and if you want to use Midjourney model 1 version 1, you can, and you can try all the ones in between. There's also a Niji model, which is, I'm gonna have to do a video for that, but it's basically the cartoon kawaii anime kind of style on here, which is really fun. And all of them, 5.1, 5.2, and the latest alpha 6. Now, another way that you can do it is you can type in --v(6.0), right? So that's the version right there. There's two ways to do it. This is actually faster if you want to just leave it on the model, the default model, and only use the alpha every once in a while. I would suggest do that. If you want to leave it on version 6, then I would do this and just leave it on here. So that's the two ways you can do it. All right, so you can see it just stays right there. I'm going to show you some of the things that I did. So the first thing we're going to do is stickers. Now, this is the prompt I use for a sticker. You can use any prompt you want. You can test this out for yourself. But here is the one I use for this video. A cute cartoon sticker of a happy corgi dog. You know, I like corgis. I made one over here eating ramen. This is just the default version. Okay, no version 6. And it's pretty cute. I like this. In fact, I think this one is the one I would choose. Some of this, the face kind of looks weird here. But let's see what version 6 did. Same one, but you can see --version 6. And this is it. So I think it's actually a great improvement. So the style version, like you can see, these are very different styles. I really love this one, this artwork right here. And the face on these corgis actually are a lot better than these faces, I think. You can see kind of iffy over here, but this one actually does better. So here's both of them side by side. So you can see, make your own choice, but I'm going to give the win to version 6 on this one. Now, every prompt may be different, but for this one, I think this corgi turned out way better. So for number 2, we're going to do posters, and this is the prompt that I use. Just really simple, a scenic poster of Tahiti. I didn't give it any other prompt, what kind of style. I could probably do it in like a vintage style. I could have asked for a photorealistic. I could have done a lot of things, but I just did really simple. A scenic poster of Tahiti, and I wanted Midjourney to figure out what does that mean. So here's the default. It's really nice. It almost looks photorealistic here. This one's cool too. I really love these colors here. So these two right here, I would say I would make this a poster, right? I would probably put the palm tree, like I would love this palm tree here, and then these colors in the background, really cool. But let's see what version 6 did. Here is the same one, a scenic poster for Tahiti. You can see --, version 6. And here it is. I love the colors on this. It kind of has like a vintage feel, even though I didn't say to do it in a vintage style. It kind of knew kind of what kind of things would be in posters, and you can see it did the palm trees on all of them. I don't know exactly what Tahiti looks like, so but just based off of the colors and a poster and just artwork, I don't know. I think this one's really cool. I think this one's really cool, but I also think I love these colors, so I think it's a wash, because I think these two are not better, but these two are better than version 6. And again, so all of these are better than the top two, in my opinion, but the bottom two just had more color on this. These two had more color. So here are the two side by side. What do you think? Let me know in the comments, but I think this one's kind of even. It kind of evened out. Even though they look different, I think the coloring on what we have today may be different. So, and of course you could put that in the prompts. Maybe that's why, because I didn't put that in the prompts, and version 6 actually listening to the prompts better than trying to just make up stuff. That could be it too. So this one I think is a wash, or a tie. This one's a tie. So number 3 is patterns. So we can do patterns, and you can put patterns on so many different things on print on demand. You know, you got blankets and pillows and phone cases, pop sockets, bags, whatever, right? So here's my prompt, very simple again, a colorful spring flower pattern. And I did --, tile, so it's a tiling pattern, which means when you come in here, it repeats, right? This flower you can see repeats there, this leaf connects to that and so on. And it should repeat if you butt them up together on top and everything. And I think this is really good. This is what we would expect. This is really nice, colorful pattern, flower pattern. I don't see anything wrong with it. Let's see version 6. So this is version 6's, and I like the variety of it. You can see different styles, like these two are in white, and this is a different kind of style. So, oh, I don't know, maybe slightly, like very slightly better. These have two styles too, I don't know. I'm gonna give this one to the current version, 5.2. I think the patterns are just slightly better in my opinion. Again, this is for this prompt, and it could be better if I use a more elaborate prompt, longer prompt, but I wanted to see what Midjourney would figure out with a simple prompt. And I'm liking more and more simple prompts with DALL-E 3, by the way, too. So that's why I'm using more simple prompts. So slightly better today than version 6 alpha. But only slightly, because these aren't bad at all, and I think these would work really well. Okay, so topic number 4, and this is one that is really interesting, and that is coloring books. How well can it do creating a coloring book page or pages, right, with simple prompts? Now, this one's not as simple. I wanted to make sure we got this right and didn't have any hiccups, so this is the prompt that I use. Printable coloring page of a cartoon unicorn and a big rainbow on a white background in the style of hand coloring, black outline, no margin, no frame. So pretty long prompt, but I just wanted to make sure there was no color in here at all. And this is what Midjourney current default 5.2 did. And you can see none of them are unicorns. This one's a horse, but no unicorn horn. This is a girl with some ears that look like a unicorn, no unicorn here. And again, a girl with unicorn ears. And the rainbow is missing. Even though I said rainbow, this has clouds, no rainbow. This has a slight rainbow. This one kind of has a rainbow, but it's not apparent. More flowers, and I didn't ask for flowers. I just said unicorn and rainbow, right? And for some reason, this has a girl, two girls. Anyway, and a bear. I didn't ask for a bear. Okay, so here it is again, version 6.0. Unicorn with rainbow, obviously unicorn, rainbow, perfect, unicorn, rainbow, and I think this one by far is doing better than the first one, the current one default. So version 6 wins this round with the coloring pages. Again, could be the prompt. I did type in unicorn and rainbow and it didn't understand that, but maybe it would understand other things, and I think this is a great coloring page. It understood the assignment. And these would make great coloring pages in my opinion. Now you can see version 6 way better in my opinion. Okay, so another one that I think is really important is t-shirt design. Now, can it understand how to make a t-shirt design with text? So I added that in the prompt. And this one has vector art, a vintage scenic outdoor design with mountains and trees with the words, take it easy on a black background. I did not say it was a t-shirt design, so maybe version 6 would need that, you'll see. So here's the first one, and I think it did great as far as the artwork. Any of these would be great on a t-shirt as outdoor, but as far as the words go, no, it did not spell, it right. But, you know, maybe version 5.2 is great for graphics and not text. So let's see what it does now in version 6, same prompt again. And here, which is interesting, I actually like the artwork in the first one than this one, but this one actually spelled it right. Take it easy. I mean, you know, it's hard to read, but it's obviously E-A-S-Y there. Take it easy, very easy to read. Not sure why it repeated it here. Take it easy. So, I mean, doesn't need that one, but it did spell it right down here. And take it easy, easy, which I don't understand. But if you look at the prompt, I said vector art, which it is, vintage scenic, which it is very vintage scenic, but it didn't add color, which maybe I needed to specify on here, and on a black background. So it did a kind of a black and white kind of scenic thing. Again, I'm gonna have to give the coloring or at least the graphics to our current model. At least for what I wanted to see out of it, right? And maybe version 6, like I said, is interpreting what vintage means. And so I have to use better words in version 6 because this really is vintage design. And I should have said for a t-shirt because this doesn't look like a t-shirt design at all. So maybe if I did that, it would actually make it better. But as far as a t-shirt design goes, I don't think any of these are great t-shirt designs, and neither are these, but I'm gonna give the win to version 5.2 just because if I took out the words, I think I could use these as t-shirt designs, and if I took out the words, I mean, these could be used, but I like the color on the other one better. So here are both of them together. You can see side by side, version 5.2 and version 6. Now I wanted to do a couple more things before I end here, and that is with photos and paintings. So let's do one. Let me show you one that I did earlier about the Mona Lisa. So I did this simple prompt and all I wrote was Mona Lisa. That's it. And this is what it came out. So default today, it kind of interpreted Mona Lisa and did it in it. It's not the exact Mona Lisa. Right, you can see it interpreted and made more modern and different, but I did the same thing with version 6. You can see all I typed in was Mona Lisa, and you can see it almost replicated what the Mona Lisa looks like today. It didn't take too many variations. It put the sun back there, and this one changed the background a little bit, but it is like classic Mona Lisa. So I think prompts, it interprets prompts a little bit different than it does today. It's maybe needs more on it, or it doesn't interpret it as much, or doesn't have as much freedom. I don't know, but the way that it does it, you can see, because I only put Mona Lisa, the very simple prompt, it is giving me that Mona Lisa. So here's another one. I did this, the dude as Santa Claus. So you can see here, very cool, the dude. If you don't know the dude is from The Big Lebowski. It's a character from The Big Lebowski. This is what he looks like right here. So it's interpreting that and kind of mashing that up with Santa Claus. So you can see very different variations. Kind of looks like a photo, actually, of the character with wearing a Santa Claus outfit. So now I did the dude as Santa Claus in version 6.0. And you can see very different. It almost stylized it a little bit. This looks like a watercolor painting. This looks like a photo. This had him as in a Hawaiian shirt as a Hawaiian Christmas. So a little bit more variations. The color is a little bit different. And these are the two side by side. So I don't know which one I like better, but you can see that it's definitely doing something different in version 6. Not sure exactly what, but I think it's interpreting it a little better, kind of giving you a little more variety in my opinion. So you can see classic Santa Claus painting of Santa Claus kind of on vacation, where these are all kind of the same. I don't know if that's true, but that's how I see it. So play around with version 6. I think sometimes it's better. It's learning, of course, learning to get better and better. It already does a great job on photos. I think that's where Midjourney is very strong in, is photos and scenery and things like that. It's getting better and better with all the other ones as well. I think my favorite one in this video is the stickers. That Kawaii dog sticker is so much better than the one that you can find out today. And I'm excited to try that Niji version as well to see how that did. So there you go. Hopefully this video is really helpful for you, so you can see the progression of what Midjourney is right now and how it can change in the future, how it can get better. It's getting better and better. And I believe when it comes out, the full version, not the beta or the alpha, when it's fully out, version 6, I think it's gonna be better in all these aspects because it's learning and growing. If you wanna see more videos about AI, I have a whole AI playlist right here. You can click on that and watch all my AI videos. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.